Can we not be so intense? And anyway, it's not that great of a story to be proud of. Do you know about this world-famous Kohinoor diamond? Do you know where it was then? Or where it is now? Where some people want it to be? Or where it should be? Blah, 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 blah. If you don't know this complicated funny story, get ready to be informed. So the Kohinoor diamond. This diamond was mined in medieval times in Kollur mines in Andhra Pradesh's Guntur district. At one time, it was considered the largest diamond in the world. The diamond was originally owned by the Kakatiya dynasty, which had installed it in the temple of Hindu goddess as her eye. Legends say that there has been a curse on this diamond which allows only goddesses and females to wear it. This diamond is a traveler. This piece of wealth has traveled across the medieval Central Asia and modern era quite a lot. It was in Andhra for a while, then it went to Delhi for a visit. It was taken to the ancient city of Samarkand from Delhi for a 300 years long vacation. After that, it came to the possession of Delhi Sultanate and then to the Mughals. It went to Persia for a while and then made its way back to Punjab. From there, it was taken to the East India Company to Lahore. Then, it boarded a ship to England to be part of the Queen's crown, and it has been a part of the same since then. A great nation asked the British numerous times for the return of the diamond, which they refused with a smile. But the funny part now is, a petition has been filed for the return of the diamond and is filed in Lahore. Yes, now the Pakistanis want it. I think we'll start asking Pakistan to return it once they get it. Just like kids asking their pencils back to their classmates, you know. Which they'll never get anyway. So this is the story of where it was then and where it is now. And where some people want it to be and where it should be.